Very grateful for especially some of our panelists tonight who are coming on NewsHour, and they are sharing with us the difficult times that they have faced while trying to fight the system after great individual tragedies. Of course, Neelam Kathara, who is such an inspiring person, mother of Nitish Kathara, is staying with us tonight. I'm grateful for that. I'm grateful to Atanu Purakayastha for coming us and joining us from our studios in Delhi. Atanu Purakayastha, welcome and thank you for coming. Father of Pallavi Purakayastha. And Pallavi Purakayastha was killed and murdered, and her killer was given parole and he's gone missing. And he's still waiting there to get an answer from the Maharashtra government, from the police, to find out where the killer is. He hasn't given up. Atanuda, thank you for coming. And I'm also grateful for Shilpa Mittal. I spoke to her sometime back before we came on the program, and I know how it's not easy for you. Shilpa lost her brother, Siddharth, in a hit and run case. And there was someone who just turned 18, 4 days after he killed Siddharth while driving his father's car. And she says she's not giving up, though her fight is long and her fight is very, very difficult. And as I introduce each of these panelists today, I also want to introduce Sambit Patra of the BJP. Sambit, thank you for staying back. Clyde Cresto of the NCP. I want to welcome Amar Prasad Satpathy of the BJD. Professor Ashok Sinha, thank you for coming. And Syed Asim Wakar of the SP. First of all, I want to say this, that don't take this as my accusation. As I said to Pawan Verma, who I respect at a personal level, don't take it as an accusation, the politicians, if you can understand where I'm coming from. Main aapko accuse nahi karna chahta. Vikram Singh hai aaj, former DGP Uttar Pradesh, one of India's best known policemen. Vikram Singh, I'm not accusing the police, I'm not interested. What do we gain with an accusation? It's not going to get somebody back. But I am concerned today. I'm deeply concerned at what's going on. But I'm also at the same time, and I want to start by asking you this, Atanuda, because I know how difficult it is for someone who has lost, his daughter, to fight in the way that you do. What gives me some sense of solace is that more and more and more Indian citizens, Atanuda, are coming out like you and saying, we are not going to give up. So I just want to begin by asking you, in your battle for justice for your own daughter, what is it that keeps you going? What has been your most difficult moment? What is your realization? And is it easy to fight? People see Neelam Kathara fighting nonstop, but I know it's not easy to fight. If you can share a bit of what you go through personally while fighting for justice, please. Atanuda.
Arnav, first of all, thank you very much for giving me a chance to voice my feeling. What keeps me going is the fact that I want to tell you today and the country, 10 days before her murder, I was just telling her that I belong to IAS and we deliver. And her case is where I have failed to deliver. And this pain keeps me going. Every morning when I get up, I look at the roof and I think that what is the next action I'm going to take? The pain, the anguish. Incidentally, today is birthday of Pallavi. If she was alive, she would have been 30 years today. I am also very much pained that a system of which I was part for 34 years has ditched me. I am unable to get justice from the same system of which I was part. And I feel that I have to fight alone and carry the cross on my shoulder for Pallavi. I was hearing the debate number 2 when gentleman was saying about the case, the framing of this charge sheet. In fact, our system has totally lost its meaning. You see, if you go by IPC 302, it clearly says, whosoever commits murder shall be punished with death. This is the opening sentence, and the second sentence is, or will be imprisoned for life. Our system is so much deteriorated that today it is, we can clearly say that whosoever commits murder will be imprisoned for life, and in rarest of rare cases will be given death punishment. Is this the motive of the lawmakers?
Yeah.
If the highest court of the land twists the implication of the law, then situation are bound to take place like this. And more people are going to suffer. And someday some people will come on the street and he will say, go to hell, the judicial system. Go to hell, the criminal administrative system. I'll take the law in my hand and I'll get justice for me. That's going to happen, and I am quite convinced now that it's going to happen. Today or tomorrow is going to happen. In the previous case, possibly the police may not have done the proper role. But in Pallavi's case, there was no doubt about the convict Sajjad committing the crime.
No, no doubt.
Yet the lower court cheated us of the justice. And then we went to the state government of Maharashtra was kind enough to move to Supreme to High Court for increasing the punishment to death punishment to capital punishment, and for four times the case was listed, and it was not heard. I went all the way from Delhi to Bombay, and in front of me the list was torn away. The court will not sit. Had the court taken up the case that time, the question of getting parole for Sajjad would not have come. So who all we are going to blame? If one day some police investigation fails, tomorrow the judicial system is failing us. So someday some people will get so much frustrated that will say, okay, forget about all those things. I am going to avenge my my pain. At my level, I am just continuing. Let me see how long I can do it. I have made appeals to the Chief Minister of Maharashtra that at least you are getting out this police this thing to arrest Sajjad. But nothing stops you from taking action against the divisional commissioner who is actually who has heaped this pain on us by giving a parole to this Sajjad. Even that also has not been done.
And viewers, Atanuda, if I may interrupt, viewers, I just want to tell you this, that today no, I'm coming to you, Mr. Satpathy. No,
Mr. Goswami, will you kindly allow me the topic which you have chosen for me?
No, I will allow you. But why can't you wait for 2 minutes?
Allow. The time was 10 to 10:30. Now it was going to be 10:35.
Yeah, good. 10:40. No, one second. Mr. Satpathy, the problem with politicians like you is that if I make you wait for half an hour, you wait because I am giving
problem.
Time to the citizen.
The problem lies with the timing factor.
So it's all
your,
right.
Your channel people who contacted me, they requested
Mr. Satpathy.
Now you are starting
yes,
with 10:40.
Yes, I have delayed this, Mr. Satpathy. Because
to me about the fire incident which took place in Bhubaneswar Swam Hospital.
Mr. Satpathy,
will you kindly allow me?
Mr. Satpathy, will you wait?
Kindly bear with me.
Mr. Basatpathy, bear with me. I'm requesting you, bear with me and please listen to me. Just wait a minute.
But my point is, I am not talking about a moral case. I am talking of the tragedy which took place.
Yeah, I am talking about the moral case. If, in case you want to know, Mr. Satpathy, I am telling you about the moral case. You people in Orissa, the ruling party of Orissa, tried to protect the owner of the hospital in which 21 people died. I'm sorry. This man surrendered, and these issues are linked. These issues are linked, and I want to know enough. enough, Mr. Satpathy. I'll tell. I don't want to talk to the viewers. Viewers, can I just tell you why these issues are linked? Can I tell you why these issues are linked? These issues are linked because I believe in this country, sometimes the politician, bureaucrat, businessman nexus does not value human life. And the gentleman from Orissa is getting angry tonight, but he knows that these issues are linked, whether it is the case. Can you stop talking for 2 minutes, please? Thank you.
All right, it's not 2 minutes, it has gone 40 minutes.
There are many other people. I'm giving a citizen of India time today on the program. I give politicians time every night. For one night, I'm giving the citizen time. Can you allow the citizen to speak? I don't understand for the life of me the problem with why does a politician get so exasperated if they have to wait?
It's not the question of politicians. The time which was 10 to 10:30. Now you are 10:45 and asking, you are telling the politicians are impatient. We are not impatient.
Okay, I'll tell you one thing. Mr. Satpathy, I'll tell you one thing. Okay, I'm being very nice to you. 21 people died. I'm discussing a serious subject and I've given a lot of voice to the citizen. If you feel you cannot wait for 5 minutes to discuss this subject, then it is your choice whether you want to participate in the program or not. Don't show me your anger. You know, if you're going to behave like this, if it's your choice, if you don't want to participate in the program, please. I mean, it's a real problem for me if you behave
like this. That's all right. That's if you say that I'll not participate, then. But I'm sitting for 45 minutes.
I really don't know what to do with. I really don't know. I'll open the phone lines now, please. You know, let people give their.
No, Arnab, let me talk to Mr. Satpathy.
Okay, but don't make
it. Mr. Satpathy, do you know the people who have lost their lives in the fire? They have to wait for all this life, but still they will not get back their children.
Okay, since you want to be asked questions, I will, but just be quiet for a while, okay? First of all, these issues are linked. Why are they linked? Because in all these cases, politicians and businessmen come together to treat the common citizen, the aam aadmi, you know, like they don't matter. The simple point is, you answer one question today. The owner of this hospital surrendered today before the Orissa police. Would he have surrendered? Right, Neelam Katara is on the program. She can tell us, she's been with us for the last few days. Would he have surrendered had we not put pressure for 48 hours? We put pressure for you. Had it not been for relentless media pressure, especially the pressure of people on the news hour tonight, would this man have been arrested? Let's put his pictures on air for the last few days. Vikram Singh, yes, Vikram Singh, I see your hand go up. You can tell us, you can tell this arrogant gentleman, this man who has surrendered today, Vikram Singh, you tell me, would he have been arrested? Would he have surrendered had we not been shouting and screaming for the last 2 days,
Arnab,
that the incompetent Orissa police, the incompetent Orissa government is trying to protect him? Vikram Singh, please speak your mind out tonight, because I'm so irritated with this gentleman, Amar Prasad Satpathy, who does not have the decency to speak properly on the news hour. Vikram Singh.
With the greatest of respect to Mr. Satpathy, your anger is totally misplaced. I would rather that you show these tantrums to the police leadership, announce rewards on the absconding accused. Now please listen to me, Mr. Satpathy. You are totally misplaced in your logic and in guiding the investigation. You have not announced rewards on the absconding accused, and there is no provision in law of people surrendering before the police. They can surrender before the court of law. And this orchestrated so-called surrender speaks volumes about the nexus between the local police administration and the accused. The leadership should be ashamed that such a surrender did take place.
You will not invoke
the provisions of the National Security Act. First listen to me, Mr. Satpathy, and then you can react. Will you invoke the provisions of the National Security Act, subclause 2, on public order? You will not. Will you confiscate the movable and immovable property of the absconding accused? You will not. You are soft pussy footing on the issue, and like Bihar, all these accused will get bail sooner than later, and then they will have the last laugh. You will put your way. First of all, let me tell you, the roadmap before you is very clear. How to give a legitimate help and assistance behind the screens to the accused so that they have a free run. Now, Mr. Satpathy, I rest my case.
You know, we are in a country. We have a judicial system, there, and we have to go by that. If somebody gets a bail, it doesn't mean that he is not the accused. In the process also, many people are convicted. Will you kindly allow me to listen?
No, the prosecution is nothing.
Allow me.
Investigation
allow me
is nothing.
No, you don't tell me about
investigation.
You have to be asked specific questions. You are from the BJD. I want to ask you specific questions. Please take my questions.
You
are in a hurry. I'll ask you very specific questions.
Kindly.
समस्तंकु सुनंतु पार्टी करंतु नी एबे ठीक है बस बसदिया सुनंतु
ओडिया लोग पार्टी करोने म आएगा दफ्तर में से के कौन जानने से कौन साइड से कौन
ना 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 सुनंतु बसंतु बसंतु
50 बाबू जाऊ
होल ऑफ 10:50 व्हाट इज 10:50 व्हाट इज 10:30 द पीपल ऑफ ओडिशा आर नॉट हैविंग द डिनर एंड दे आर वेटिंग टू सी व्हाट काइंड ऑफ डिस्कशन द ओडिया पीपल आर गोइंग टू हैव ओवर हियर ओवर द डेड बॉडी
इट इज नॉट
एंड यू आर यू आर हैविंग टू गो टू योर होम टू स्लीप
Because
you
don't have much time for you not prepared all life. I take I beg
I'll ask
you.
I'll ask you three or
leave.
Four questions.
I am taking leave.
No,
I am the you, way you are talking.
Don't run away.
Then I
don't
I take
run
leave.
I am flabbergasted at what's going on tonight. I don't understand these politicians, you know. I don't understand how someone can behave like this.
But will you allow me to speak?
Neelam Kathara is something. Then I'd like to go to Shilpa, please. I don't want to. Yeah, Syed Asim Wakar ji, boliye. Mr. Wakar ji, kuch keh rahe hain? Yes, Mr. Wakar.
No, I absolutely understand.
I ek se 1.5 minute chahta hu. Main chahta hu ki meri baat pure mulk ke log sune. देखिए ये सिर्फ उड़ीसा का या भुवनेश्वर का सवाल नहीं है.
He is walking off.
हमारे हिंदुस्तान के सब हर इलाके का और हर शहर का सवाल है. हमारे कानून का सवाल है. चाहे कोई हॉस्पिटल
He is walking off.
चाहे कोई सड़क हो. सुन लीजिए जिस मुल्क अरे सुनिए मेरे भाई संबित पात्रा जी.
नहीं ये ऐसे नेता है जो प्रोग्राम के बीच में उठ के जा रहे हैं कह रहे मेरे पास टाइम नहीं है. Amazing. 21 people die, viewers. Please notice this moment. I feel this is an inflection point. 21 people die, and this man does not have the time to talk about it. He has come on a program and he walks off. I cannot believe this.
I cannot believe this. हमारे मुल्क में जब इस तरह के लोग होंगे जो ये कहें कि जब बड़ा पेड़ गिरता है तो धरती हिलती है या 2002 में बयान आ जाए कि क्रिया की प्रतिक्रिया होती है जब इस तरह के हिंदुस्तान
No, I want to go to Shilpa Mittal.
तो कमजोर अपने आप होगा.
No, I want to go to Shilpa Mittal right now. Shilpa, I'm sorry to keep you waiting for so long. I had to give everyone equal time before speaking. I'm really sorry you had to wait, especially because of the person, gentleman from Orissa out there from the BJD, the way he behaved. Now, Shilpa, like I began by asking Mr. Atanu Purakayastha about how difficult his fight is, and I spoke to you right before the program, and I asked you that you said yourself that you are continuing to fight for your brother because you want to prove that all is not lost, and you want to prove that within the system that a person can fight and win. And viewers, I just want to tell you about this particular case. Siddharth Sharma, I think he was 32 years old, marketing consultant, killed in a hit and run case, right? And it is extremely difficult in this case. The juvenile board had picked up this particular case. This particular case was one where this teenager who was just 4 days short of 18 had been fined twice for speeding and once for parking wrongly. And I want you to tell all our viewers tonight, if for nothing else but to inspire them about the need to fight the injustice in the system, can you tell us, Shilpa, how difficult your fight has been and how you feel when you see cases like Rocky Yadav's, like the 21 people who died in Odisha, right? When you hear about Neelam Kathara's fight and what Atanu Purakayastha feels about what happened to his daughter and what happened to the case after that. Shilpa.
Thank you for giving me this opportunity to talk what I'm thinking. See, it's not easy to lose somebody in your life who's been, everything in your life, and suddenly he just disappears one day and you don't know what's going to happen, because you, as a layman, as a common man who's actually right now watching the news, I was one of them. I don't know how the law and order works. I don't know how the police works. Nothing. I'm a common man who doesn't know much about it, all these things. But then suddenly this happens, and then you have to face everything that's there in the system. It's so difficult because nobody is actually there to help you. The system makes you so handicapped and so lost. You have no idea what's happening. There are so many things happening at the same time. There's nothing happening. I have been watching the cases, and it's just heartbreaking for the simple reason. I have been very firm about one thing, that we have lost Siddharth, and no matter what happens, no justice is gonna bring Siddharth back. But I'm very, very clear about one thing, that this case is not about revenge. I don't want the father or the son in this case or in any other case to just be, you know, killed or hanged or, you know, given the punishment, because that is not the end of it. That is not what I'm expecting. I'm not expecting revenge. I'm expecting that the law and order should be so strict that people like them should not think that they, because they have deep pockets or they have the power or whatever they think they have, can actually get away with the murder. This is actually a murder, and there are murders happening everywhere, and people can get away with it. They have been. That's why they are doing it in the first place. The jurisdiction has such a lame system because everything gets delayed. Now you have dates after dates after date. This whole process is so exhausting because it's financially exhausting, it's mentally exhausting. I actually quit my job to go to the courts and run after police and the courts and the lawyers and everything. Thankfully, media helped us out. They actually made us raise our issue, and some people started listening to us where the case actually stands today. Otherwise, it was an open and a shut case on the first day. And this happens every day with every person. It's such a heartbreaking thing because my father, my grandfather was a freedom fighter. My father has served Navy, the defense, and when something happens to his son, he was my only brother. And nobody is helping us out, and this is what you get after serving the nation. You know, the torture that you go through every day, and all the politicians here, Mr. Gentleman who walked away right now, I think he should be really ashamed. I think I'm very ashamed that we elected people like them who don't even care about people like us. It's absolutely shameful because nobody wants to take a stand. Everybody wants to give their, you know, opinions and come into the debate and then give big lectures. But actually, when it comes to performance, nothing else.
हमारे जैसे सैकड़ों और हजारों लाखों लोग आपके साथ खड़े हैं, और ये बात मत कहिए कि कोई आपके साथ
नहीं है। सर, आप मेरे साथ एक दिन कोर्ट आइए। सर, आप एक दिन मेरे साथ कोर्ट आइए। आपको पता चलेगा कि आप कैसे खड़े रहते हैं। इतना आसान नहीं है आपका कहना और मेरा रोज उस चीजों को झेलना। सर, मैं रोज डेट
से वॉकर जी बोलने दीजिए, बोलने दे शिल्पा जी को प्लीज। नहीं वो नहीं, प्लीज सैयद अकील वॉकर जी सुनिए सुनिए सुनिए। नहीं 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 नहीं, ये जो बातें कह रही हैं आप बताइए आज। नो नो शिल्पा वन मिनट, पहले तो आपसे दरखास्त करता हूँ, आप इंटरप्ट मत कीजिए। दो बातें सुनिए आज, मैं कुछ नहीं कह रहा हूँ, मैं सुनना चाहता हूँ।
राजकुमार ने एक आम आदमी का,
सर आपको हमने वोट किया है, आप हमारी बात तो सुन लीजिए।
आप दो मिनट सुन तो लीजिए।
काटी गई है और उस आम आदमी का केस किसी ने नहीं लड़ा।
आप दो मिनट सुन तो ले,
आम आदमी का जिसका मर्डर हुआ था उसका केस सरकार ने लड़ा।
नहीं नहीं नहीं, शायद असीम वकर जी, क्या आपको, क्या आप, नो नो वन, मिस्टर वकर आप रुकेंगे, आप रुकेंगे दो मिनट,
शर्मा की बातें सुन ले, थोड़ी तवज्जो।
वन सेकंड प्लीज विक्रम सिंह, आई थिंक वी शुड लिसन टू शिल्पा एंड वी शुड लिसन टू मिस्टर पुरकायस्ता एंड वी शुड लिसन टुनाइट टू नीलम कटारा। कैन आप दो मिनट रुक जाए शिल्पा प्लीज,
कैन आई एम टॉकिंग
प्लीज ऑन द स्क्रीन प्लीज, या थैंक यू, प्लीज कैन यू स्टॉप।
सर, आई एम नॉट एक्यूजिंग योर एनीबॉडी,
थैंक यू।
I am just saying, as a layman, the system is so tiring. आपको रोज भागना पड़ता है। आपने कभी, आप imagine भी नहीं कर सकते हैं courts में क्या हालत होती है। हम घंटों घंटों खड़े रहते हैं courts के बाहर क्योंकि हमारी date आएगी, और judges भी overloaded है, उनकी गलती नहीं है, but the system is such कि वो लोग इतना overloaded है, 5 मिनट से ज़्यादा वो किसी case को दे नहीं सकते। And obviously our system is such कि जिसमें आपको allow किया जाता है कि आज ये court, आज advocate नहीं आए, आज कुछ और reason है, अगले दिन कुछ और reason है। We keep going through this.
No, no, Shilpa, can I just come in 1 second, and I before I come to you, Clyde, because I know you've been waiting.
Sure.
But please remember here, aur Syed Asim Bakar ji, aap ye yaad rakhiye,
कि इन 2002 एंड नीलम कटारा कैन कंफर्म दिस, आफ्टर नीलम कटारा फियर्ड मिसकैरेज ऑफ जस्टिस इन उत्तर प्रदेश बिकॉज ऑफ द वीआईपी स्टेटस ऑफ द अक्यूज नीलम कटारा, द सुप्रीम कोर्ट डायरेक्टेड द केस टू बी हर्ड इन अ कोर्ट इन दिल्ली. डजंट द फैक्ट नीलम कटारा दैट यू हैड नो फेथ इन द गवर्नमेंट, यू हैड टू मूव टू द सुप्रीम कोर्ट फॉर जस्टिस, मेक इट एविडेंट दैट द सरकार, जो सरकार कह रहे हैं ना, जो सैयद असीम वकर कह रहे हैं, हम पे भरोसा कीजिए, हम सरकार है. यू हैड नो फेट इन द सरकार ऑफ उत्तर प्रदेश, एंड जस्ट लाइक टुडे इन द केस ऑफ आदित्य सचदेवा, हैड नो कंसर्न फॉर इट्स पब्लिक लाइव्स, डू नॉट मैटर देन, लाइव्स डोंट मैटर नाउ. यस नीलम कटारा, प्लीज नीलम कटारा, यू कैन टेल सैयद असीम वकर व्हाट यू फील.
नो अर्णब, Arnab, my problem was not with the police in UP. My problem was that DP Yadav's goons, about 200 of them, would wear black coats and be there in the court. So the judge was completely intimidated. And I mean, I could not get to that court. I could not find a lawyer to appear there. So this is the, and he was an MP in the Rajya Sabha. So this is my problem with criminals and politics. That just the fear was so much that I would not have got justice over there, even though the charge sheet was filed and the charge sheet has held out and we have got a conviction all the way up to the Supreme Court. But these politicians, they can
take a break and come back.
They can completely slow down the process by just
ब्रेक ले रहा हूँ. शिल्पा प्लीज स्टे ऑन, शिल्पा प्लीज स्टे ऑन, नीलम कटारा प्लीज स्टे ऑन, विक्रम स्टे ऑन, आई एम सॉरी आई विल कम टू यू क्लाइड, आई विल कम टू यू ऑन द अदर साइड ऑफ अ ब्रेक, आई जस्ट हैव टू टेक अ ब्रेक, अदरवाइज वुडंट हैव, आई हैव टू टेक अ वेरी वेरी शॉर्ट ब्रेक, आई एम गोइंग टू कम बैक ऑन दिस बिकॉज इफ इट इज अबाउट वैल्यूइंग ह्यूमन लाइव्स, लेट्स टेक दिस डिस्कशन फॉरवर्ड. अतुनिता प्लीज स्टे ऑन, आई विल सी यू ऑन द अदर साइड. I thank our panelists for waiting. It's past 11 on the News Hour tonight. Clyde wants to say something to you, Shilpa. And Clyde Crasto is an NCP politician. And Atanu Purakayastha, you know, the NCP was in power. So in a way, we can say, you know, when your daughter was killed, and in a way, it can be said that the Maharashtra government, the NCP government, then is answerable to Mr. Atanu Purakayastha, who not only lost his daughter to a gruesome crime, but justice eludes him because the killer of his daughter is scot-free, because the system of which you were in power did not take the steps to ensure that he did not jump his parole. So we have, in a way, Mr. Clyde Crasto represents that system. He wants to say something to you as well, Atanuda. Clyde, go on.
You know, Arnab, after listening to everybody, if I speak as a, you know, spokesperson of a political party, or if I make a political statement, I think I'll fail in my duty as a human being today. So I really don't want to make any statements that would be contrary to what everybody's been talking about. All I feel that, you know, somewhere we all seem to have failed. We failed in answering, you know, Mr. Atanu or Shilpa or Nilamji. I mean, I have no words to say what, you know, what can be said.
But why, what is the reason for this? What is the reason for this? It has to be indifference at one point.
Like Mr. Atanu said, you know, during that time when it was happening, our government did appeal to the higher courts. They did appeal to the higher courts. But, well, he jumped parole, and I think there is a failure somewhere in the system. But like I said earlier...
The bigger story then, you could just pass it off as a failure.
I'm not passing it on. You know, like I said, after listening to all these people, I mean, they have lost someone they love. And when you lose someone you love, those living, you know, they die 1,000 deaths every day. I have lost someone close to me, maybe not in a situation like theirs. But to lose someone is to, you know, die 1,000 deaths every day. So I really don't want to make any political statements today, nor do I want to justify anything that has been done. All I can say, you know, it's somewhere if we have failed, it's, you know, even sorry is a smaller word today. Sorry is a smaller word today.
Do you see any change happening here? Atanu Purakayastha, do you see any significant change? We had a politician who walked off the program tonight. We have some others who do political battles on these issues. Do you see a fundamental change at any level, Atanu Purakayastha? Do these media crusades add up? I'm going to open up the phone lines in just a bit. But I don't know. If you ask me, are the politicians less indifferent? I don't think so. I don't think so. Because I still find the same kind of comments happening. I remember what Mulayam Singh Yadav said, for example, when 34 children below the age of 15 died in Muzaffarnagar in camps due to cold. He said, this is not Siberia. I don't know if you remember that comment. He said, this is not Siberia.
So
the insensitivity hasn't gone. No. I don't see it gone.
Mr. Mulayam Singh had also commented about this rape case. One of the cases, कभी 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 लड़कों से ऐसे गलतियां हो जाती हैं. You remember this was that was a very sensational thing he said, and he did not even apologize to that.
हम सब ने कंडेम किया था.
He never said sorry.
He didn't say sorry.
Please do not justify. He never said.
No, he didn't say sorry.
No, none from the party. None from the party said sorry. Please keep shut. None from my party said sorry. I'll tell you, in the parliament, your parliament, your MP, Mrs. Jaya Bachchan had shed crocodile tears. But when Mulayam Singh said this, she did not utter a single word. What are you talking?
अरे आप किस तरह की बात कर रहे हैं आप?
देखिए
सुनिए मैं बात
कह रहा हूं रिड्यूस द वॉल्यूम
पिछले 4 साल से झेल रहा हूं
प्लीज लेट अतरुदा स्पीक
झेल रहा हूं और मुझे मालूम है मुझ पे क्या बीत रहा है हमारे फैमिली पे क्या बीत रहा है आपको कुछ नहीं मालूम और उसके बाद जो व्हेन पीपल इन पोजीशन मेक सच कमेंट्स इट पेंस मोर
आप आज तो आप मैं मिस्टर वकर जी आज तो आप कभी ये बात सुनिए. देखिए मैं आपसे विनती कर रहा हूँ अच्छी तरह से. मैं आपको ना डांट रहा हूँ ना फटकार रहा हूँ. आप मेरी बात सुनिए. आज तो थोड़ी सी इंसानियत दिखाइए. जो व्यक्ति इधर बैठे हुए हैं प्रोग्राम पर उन्होंने अपने बेटी को खोया है. आप थोड़ी सी इंसानियत दिखाइए थोड़ी सी.
नहीं मुझे इंसानियत की जरूरत नहीं है. बट यू प्लीज डू नॉट मेक फॉल्स कमेंट्स. आप ऐसा मत बोलिए कि जो चीज हुआ नहीं है उसको मत बंद बोलिए.
एक सार्थक बहस करिए सर.
मैं सार्थक बहस की बात कर रहा हूँ. आप तो बीच में टपक के कहने लगे हैं. मैं तो
अच्छा एनीवे आई डोंट वांट टू
व्हाट
नो अच्छा जस्ट अतनुदा विक्रम सिंह वांट्स टू से समथिंग टू यू एट दिस पॉइंट. यू नो माय पॉइंट व्हिच आई एम हाइलाइटिंग इन ऑल ऑफ दीस केसेस आई बिगन बाय सेइंग दैट टुडे डोंट टेक इट पर्सनली बट फैक्ट इज दैट you know case after case is there where people die. 25 people died in the Varanasi stampede this time due to the failure of the administrative machinery. People lose their lives, people fight the system. And Vikram Singh, the point that I'm underlining is that in this is the same country where tomorrow, you know, a film star like Salman Khan gets away, you know, he gets his form of justice in that case. And Mohammed Shahabuddin, whose name has come up in 40 criminal cases related to murder, extortion, abduction, is granted bail in Bihar. So it's that irony which I am unable to explain. And somewhere I feel people watching this program will begin to feel that there is no sense of justice. And only VIPs in this country or VVIPs get justice. Vikram Singh.
Absolutely, Arnab. You said it. You show me the man and I will show you the rules. This seems to be the syndrome and the roadmap for the criminal justice system. I salute all the ladies and gentlemen present in the panel today for their forbearance, their fortitude, in spite of what I have heard, and I'm sure it will bleed anybody's heart after listening to what they have said. Okay. And there is little, in spite of the fact that the criminal justice system has failed them and the nation has failed them, and yet they have come to the channel, they are so patient, and they're telling the story so that others may learn. The criminal justice system, if they have any shame left, they could come up and rise to the occasion. And we had one panelist saying that 235 pages of the charge sheet, was there any pitch, substance and relevance in the charge sheet? One panelist walks off the stage because he wanted to synchronize his watch with I don't know whose watch.
Yeah, yeah.
The anguish. I had a taxi driver from Odisha today who said that I will not have lunch, sir, because I am absolutely shocked by the tragedy of Bhubaneswar that this happened in Delhi or not. A taxi driver has more sense, more sensitivity than the honorable panelist who came and walked off.
Well said.
The news are.
Yeah, Shilpa.
What to say? Where ignorance is bliss, is folly to be wise.
Yeah, Shilpa.
And to all these politicians, I would say, the John Donne's lines, do not send to know for whom the bells toll, because they toll for thee.
I'd like Shilpa to come in, please. Shilpa, you've listened to this, you've told me before the program today that it's not easy to get up every day and to fight the system and to motivate yourself. I can imagine what goes through your mind when you see debates like this, sometimes when you see somebody walking off, politicians taking credit. I don't see real remorse. But yet I want you to tell my viewers tonight, you know, what goes through your mind and what makes you believe that you can still fight. We are with you. I am with you. I mean, in whichever capacity we in the media are with you. But what does it take for you to show the fortitude that you do, Shilpa?
See, I have decided that me and my family and our very close friends have decided that we are not fighting here alone for Siddharth, because Siddharth is never going to come back, and we are trying to still, you know, come to terms with what has happened. But we have decided that unless somebody takes a stand and change the system and, you know, try to get justice, and maybe we can show the other people, those who actually can't stand up or maybe just give up very quickly because they know it's going to take time. We just want to tell them that if, you know, there is a way, you can actually fight and get away and, you know, maybe find a way and fight for justice, because running away is just making all these people more powerful.
Yeah.
And I think that it's really important for, you know, the time has come that we have to actually set an example. And the justice system, which is really, really slow, which is really old, I think it needs a lot of changes, and I'm fighting for it, that it has to be changed so that nobody suffers the loss like we are.
I'll just take two quick callers tonight. Shriram Patnaik from Hyderabad first, please. Briefly, Shriram, I'm really running short of time. Sorry to keep you waiting. Shriram from Hyderabad. Shriram, are you there? Yeah.
Good evening, Anand sir.
Good evening. Good evening, Shriram. Yeah.
My deep condolence for all the people who have died at Hyderabad. I'm Bhubaneswar, Odisha. I'm basically from Bhubaneswar, and it rips my heart when I hear this kind of news. And honestly, it's my parents who feel so bad about it. They are afraid of visiting any hospital these days. And it is not just me. It's just like any of my friends, if I talk to them, if I speak to my friends at Bhubaneswar, it's the same issue. Now, I'm surprised the gentleman, Mr. Amar Prasad Saraswati, he left without even raising a point, without even talking.
Yeah.
And I want to pass out a message to Mr. Naveen Patnaik that at least he should inform their MLAs and other party members at least to follow certain decorum at this moment, at this need of the hour.
Okay, Shriram.
I feel pity about Odisha being always mentioned as the most backward state of our country, and this is the news that again pathetic. A few months back, I hope everyone remembers, there
was Mr. Dhanamani
who carried the dead body of his wife.
I remember that. I spoke about that yesterday. Shriram, sorry I have to cut you short because I have to go to Ravindran from Chennai. Ravindran, hi, good evening.
Yeah, hi Arnab. I just have a quick point. Regarding, in between the political and business nexus, but I'll also, I mean, it's heartbreaking stories of, a brother and a son and a daughter who have lost, and then fighting, with the politicians, with the government, with the, entire system. And also, I would have been happier if there is a, judicial, somebody like Ariman Sundaram on the panel, because to see the perspective of the judicial. judiciary here and see what to what extent, you know, they are involved in the entire scheme of things. Because I think we when we go to the courts to get justice, I think they have to be the guardians of people who have lost their you know, brothers or sisters or sons and daughter, which is very heartbreaking. It can happen.
Yes, I mean,
today,
I know.
Like Siddharth's sister was saying, that she was, you know, maybe some years back she was saying this. So I'm saying that, sure, it could happen to me.
Yes.
So where do I go? I think
Ravindran, you make a very substantive point about the need to engage the judiciary, the lawyers. If you remember, I began the program tonight by saying I don't know how any politician, bureaucrat, businessman, lawyer or judge can sleep well after hearing of the stories that we've put out today. I thank you for calling in, and I thank everyone for staying up late with me on the News Hour this evening and for raising your voice. This is a campaign that we've been running for a long time, and in a way they all link up, from End VVIP Racism to this campaign to value human lives. Especially to Atanuda and to Shilpa and to Leelam Katara for coming tonight. I thank you for joining me on the News Hour tonight. Thank you.